Coffee, ready to go.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Kayla and this is going to be my first video. I'm going to be filming it to try to get ready with me, so you know, you get to know me a little bit more. Without further ado, let's get on with the video. Okay, so today I have nothing really to do. I'm thinking of doing just like a face mask before I do my makeup. It's currently 10:02. My best friend's coming over. We're gonna work on our science fair project. I think I'm going pretty natural, but like, when I say natural, I mean like, full glam natural, you know? All right, I'm obsessed with these masks. These are the Skin Therapy Retinol Facial Sheet Mask. This is supposed to rejuvenate, smooth, and revitalize. These, you probably have these at Target. I don't know, I got them for Christmas. Says to leave it on for 15 to 20 minutes. I will be back in probably 20 minutes.
Yeah, so it's been 20 minutes. So I'm gonna take this off. Whoa. I'm just gonna rub the rest of my serum into my skin to kind of get it prepped and ready. And my skin's super red, but I feel like that happens because I do have super sensitive skin. As you can probably tell, I changed my background. I flip this way. I think this is a better setup for me, so yeah. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to prime using my Mario Badescu. This is like the green tea spray. I am obsessed with this. This makes my face feel super hydrated in the sprays. While that's setting into my skin, I'm actually gonna do my brows while I'm waiting. So I like to do my brows with my, this is just like an e.l.f. eyebrow pencil. This is in the shade neutral brown. Since I do have pretty thick and fuller brows, I like to just fill in the sparse areas. Pretty natural, don't really see a difference. You can see casting. I do is I like to set my brows. This is the Maybelline Brow Drama. This just gives my brows a nice tint. I like to use this every day, even if I'm not wearing makeup, just like a little, like, you know, just brush it through and it makes it look a little more presentable. Is super like big, it's like a ball, but I feel like if you have super super thin brows you won't like this as much. I don't know, that's just me. So now I'm gonna go ahead and prime. The first thing I like to do is I like to prime, not necessarily prime, but this is the On the Spot Acne Treatment by Neutrogena. I like to put this all the places where I have acne. So I like to put this all places. All I have acne. I have acne on my nose. I feel like a lot of people have acne on their nose as well. My chin and on my forehead. So I did film like a vlog when we went tubing. And I filmed the vlog, but my face is so close to the camera, so it's not like the best angle. So I don't know if I'm gonna upload that. If I upload it, you'll see it before this video. Next, I like to use the Benefit Pore Professional. This is literally a holy grail of mine. Well, it is now. I just recently tried this and it literally makes my face look poreless, as it obviously says. Okay. So this has like a color tint, but it goes away. Daily, I don't wear foundation. I actually don't wear foundation at all because I do have freckles, as you can probably see. And I like seeing my freckles. I don't know, I feel like it just gives me, I don't know. I feel like I don't need foundation, so I don't wear it. As you know, some people do. I think it's a personal preference. I don't. Although I have been using a foundation as a primer. As a what? I have been using a foundation as a concealer and it works super well. Next thing has been one of my favorite primers. I use this over all my high-end primers. This is my e.l.f. Hydrating Face Primer. This has such an a nice texture to it. Like, it's literally like silicone-y, but at the same time, it's like not. Like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, it just hydrates my face really, really nicely. So I put the professional in my T-zone in places where I do have really big pores, which would be in this area right here and on my forehead. And I just apply this everywhere else because I do have combo skin. I feel like I'm super dry here, but I get super oily there as well. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but it's super, super weird. I'm gonna do a little bit of concealer underneath my eyes and on my lids. This is just a way for priming. So I'm gonna start off by using my Catrice Liquid Camouflage. This is a new shade Porcelain. I'm pretty pale, so this is the light shade and it fits me. So if you're lighter than me, I don't know if I have a shade for you. I wish they had more shades for like people with darker skin tones could use this, but you know. This is also waterproof, so I love taking this on vacation with me. So I'm just gonna do a little bit under the eyes. And on my lids. And then I've been obsessed with taking this concealer, this foundation, and using it as concealer. This is the NARS Velvet Foundation Stick. This isn't a sample when I ordered the Prism Palette, and I have been obsessed with this. So I just take this a flat brush, and I just literally drag it on top of that other concealer. I'm well aware you don't need both, but like, this one's a little too yellow for me. And the other one's more of like a neutral color. So. To set, I'm using my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Pressed Powder. The brush I'm using is this Eco Tools, like it's a large shadow brush. I am obsessed with the Eco Tools brush sets. I got it for Christmas and I love it. I'm just gonna set under the eye and on my lid because the palette that I'm using does not have like a setting shade that I would prefer to use. I usually love the Tempera shade in the Modern Renaissance. The Modern Renaissance is literally my favorite palette. It's like my most used palette. And I'm gonna take my Technique sponge, and I'm literally just gonna blend down the concealer. Because I'm looking, I don't know why, but I'm super red today. Take the excess and just kind of blend it everywhere. I'm gonna do contour. I'm obsessed with using this Sephora Pro contour palette. It literally is like a dupe for the ABH one. And I love the ABH one. I have it. And I've been using this one. And I don't know what. So I'm going to take this shade right here on this. This is like a Glam & Beauty. Like, it's just like a powder brush. I love using this for contour and bronzer. It's just good to me. I'm just going to put it in the hollows of my cheek. Because I do have a pretty big forehead. And on the jawline to make an illusion that I don't have fortunes. So there's another girl. Her name is Alicia Ross. She goes to my school as well. And she started making a YouTube channel and she kind of inspired me. I'm gonna DM her later and be like, yo, you inspired me to make a YouTube channel. She's super, super nice and super humble. She's in one of my classes. Oh. Okay, that was a bit much. Okay, I'm just gonna try to blend it out. She's super, super nice. She's a few grades older than me, but she's in one of my classes, and I don't know, she's just super humble and super nice. That's a really harsh contour. That's okay. I'm not leaving my house anyway, so. But yeah. I feel like when I was making the vlog, Justin goes, I'm not gonna be your first subscriber. Justin is my nephew. He goes, I'm not gonna be your first subscriber because I don't want to be that lonely one subscriber. So Cece, so my best friend's cousin, her name is Cece. She said, I'll be your first subscriber. That was cute. I'm not doing this for subscribers. I think this is just a really cool opportunity to make YouTube videos. So for bronzer, I'm using the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. This is my favorite bronzer ever. This smells so good. It smells like sunscreen and like coconut. It smells so good. I'm also using the same brush just to kind of warm up the face. I kind of like to use neutral to like cooler tones for bronzers and contour because I have such a red complexion that like it's not red. I feel like I'm just naturally red. I don't know. And I do get sunburn a lot. More of like an orangey kind of red tone, so I feel like those just even out my skin tone nicely. I do have ears that I usually put on with my makeup, but I don't know where it is and I'm super annoyed. Channel, I was also thinking of doing, you know, like hauls and like vlogs and lifestyle videos. I don't know, I thought it'd be pretty cool. So now I'm going in with this Tarte blush in the shade Party, and the lid broke because I dropped it and it didn't shatter. I was super excited. I was super like stoked that it didn't shatter because it was on my wood floor and I just dropped it. I was like, to apply this, I've been obsessed with the stippling brush. I actually got the technique from Jasmine Juicy Jazz. I'll link her channel down below. She's so nice. I don't never met her in person, but I've talked to her before and she's super nice. This is the e.l.f. small stipple brush. As you can probably tell, I don't have a lot of high-end brushes, but I feel like I don't know, I feel like if I find my holy grails, I really don't like go to a different option because I love it, you know? So next I'm going to highlight. I'm highlighter obsessed. If you know any of my friends will tell you I am literally highlighter obsessed. I'm using two because this one's too dark for me and the other one's too light for me, so mix them together and they make a really nice combo. This is the Becca Champagne Pop. This I got this from BK. Her name is Kayla as well, but we're like family friends and I call her BK. And she got this for me for my birthday, and I have literally been using it ever since my birthday. I love Jaclyn Hill. I support her. Yes. So I'm just going to put this on my Wet n Wild crease brush. You can't even see it because I've used this so much. I'm just going to put this right on the high points of my cheek, just right there. Tap it a little bit more. Oh, that's so pretty. So this is typically what I do for school as well. Like, I do wake up relatively early just to get ready. I just love the fact of makeup. I don't know. I just do. And to go over to make it a little more suitable for my skin tone, I'm going in with this MAC highlighter. This is in the shade Lightscapade. This is super, super light. But, like, I like it. I keep it for, like, making highlighters that are too dark light enough for me. That's super nice. I'm obsessed. Did you guys see the Soft Glam palette from AVH? Oh my god, it's so pretty. I posted on my spam about it. I will link all my social medias down below. I just recently made a Twitter and I am obsessed. I love Twitter. Like, I've seen, so like, I love baseball as well. So when, like, I was looking and I followed the Red Sox as well as the Houston Astros. I'm obsessed with the Astros. They're so good. But, like, they're so funny tweets. There's so many funny memes and it's so nice. So now I'm going to go into my eyes. I'm actually going to get you guys a little bit closer. Or, I tried to zoom in as best as I could without it looking, like, really weird. Yeah. So, I already primed my lids. I'm actually gonna spray my skin with a little bit more of that Mario Badescu spray to kind of make it look a little less powdery. The first palette I'm gonna go in with is the AVH Subculture. It's super pretty. I'm using a few shades in here. I know there's a lot of controversy about this palette. I still really love this. The only shade that does not blend for me is the shade Destiny, which is a super this super nice green shade. I wish it did because it's such a beautiful green. I've used every other color. Doesn't look very dented, but it'll get there soon. But I think I've used every color except for this one. I don't know what I'm gonna do with gray, but I think it's super pretty. Anastasia is my favorite brand. Love. So in the shade Dawn, this is a really nice light shade with this Real Techniques blending brush. I literally use like 3 brushes for my eyes, and I'm just going to put this in my crease. This is, whoa, I dipped into that a bit more. This is a little darker than what it is on the pan, but I really like it. So this year the science fair is required for us, and I don't know how I feel about it. I feel like the science fair is such a good opportunity for us to like learn about different things that we want to, but at the same time, like, I don't have time for this. I have so many other projects. I cannot speak. So many other projects to worry about, and this just on top of it does not help. I feel like people said high school was really hard compared to what it, I don't know what it actually is. I feel like high school is not, I mean, it's hard, but it's not as hard as what they say it was, and I don't really understand. Everybody's like, oh my god, you know, seniors pick on freshmen. No, they really don't. Like, I've never been picked on by a senior. My cousin's a senior. You guys will see if I like start vlogging on the daily or whatever, like you'll see I'm like always with her, or I'm with nobody, or I'm with Ariel and Trin, and me and Bella, we're starting to hang out again together, which is really great because so for some reason I've always been scared to start a YouTube channel. I feel like, I don't know, I feel like I've never been, I wouldn't be accepted by like my town if they like found it, be like, oh my god. Like, but like, I feel like as I got older, I don't really, people and what they say doesn't really bother me anymore, which I'm super happy. Oh, excuse me. What they say doesn't really bother me as much. Some people of what they say, you know, if I like, I really, like, I love hanging out with them, and like things that they may say may hurt a little more, but I feel like I can take a hit or two. Feel like you're gonna get a lot of criticism, but like I feel like that's not gonna bother me. I mean, obviously it's gonna get to me sometimes, but I'm still on that one shade guy. And I want to get a tripod, but I don't know which ones are the best, you know. I'm also filming on my phone. I have a camera, but the SIM card doesn't want to work, so I'm filming my camera. These two yellow and orange shades are giving me life, but I want to do more of like a warm brown look, so I'm going to switch palettes. I'm going to go back to this palette, but I do this. So I'm going to go in with my Violet Voss Nicole Concealio palette. I am obsessed with this palette, one of my favorites. I got this like pre-order, so I got a little photo of her, and it says like, you work girl. I'm like, I fangirled so hard. So for my next kind of like transition-y shade, I'm going in with the shade Pizza and Hangry. This is, if you guys don't know who Nicole Concilio is, she is a makeup influencer on YouTube. She is so beautiful, and I literally, I binge watch her YouTube videos. Also with Kim Tai. I can't even tell you. I was up till like 2 a.m. because I could not sleep. And I was binge watching baseball because I want the season to start. I'm so ready for spring training. Oh, yes. Ooh. I'm looking at myself in the mirror because I'm weird. But, like, I was watching her. Baseball, Kim Tai, like. Oh, and Tati. Tati is, like, the most. She's just perfect, okay? We're going on the shade Pizza and Hangry, which is just this. Pizza is just, like, a warm brown kind of shade, and Hangry is just, like, a lighter, more orangey shade of this. So I'm taking this on the same brush, and I'm just going to run this into the crease. Shade. I'm not using this one, I'm using this one. This one is blue. I'm using Hangry. I'm sorry. I'm new at this. So there's a shade. It is called Hey Gal. This one, I found a dupe for it. So much cheap. It's so cheap, but I feel like I just love it. I don't know. It's from Maybelline. It's like a single shadow. It is so, so pretty. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I feel like in my background to the video, I'm gonna film like this, but I'm gonna play like a little fire or something. I don't know. For some reason, I feel super comfortable in front of the camera. I don't know how to explain it. I'm going in with the shade Boop Bop, kind of like a neutral brown. And I'm gonna mix that in with the shade Hey Gal, the one that I love. I do have some really fun vlogs, you guys, coming up. I'm just putting this right on my lid and blending it into my crease. I'm gonna have some fun upcoming vlogs because next month my aunt is getting married in Punta Cana. So we are gonna go. You're gonna see lots of good pictures, lots of good footage. Yes. This morning I was watching Jeffree Star, and this is so off topic, but I was watching Jeffree Star and Tana Mojo recreating each other's looks, and it, I don't know, just inspired me. I love feeling inspired. So a little bit more about me. I do play sport, I play softball. I love softball. I feel like it's just such a so important part of my life. I'm going in with this Anastasia brush. It comes with the like any palette that they give you. I use the other side for concealer. Now I'm gonna use this side. I've never used this side before. It's just a fluffy blending brush, and I'm gonna use this to buff out my edges to make it super smoky and blown out. I'm obsessed with not doing like a black liner, shadow liner, but doing like a dark brown shadow liner right on my upper lash line. Okay. I'm gonna take this Glam and Beauty. This is like a little angled brush. I don't know if you can see it. Don't mind my chubby little fingers. I'm gonna take the shade Chocolate, and I'm gonna mix it with the Subculture's Fudge to make like a perfect little brown shade. Chocolate's a little more deeper than Fudge. I'm gonna get real close, and I'm just gonna try to dry that on the lash. Baseball players. So as I was talking about baseball before, I love the Little League World Series. Me and my grandparents, me and my grandfather have been watching it together ever since we were little. And then we decided to go for a Christmas trip for his Christmas present. I told him we were gonna go, I'd pay for his room, and we had so much fun. And that was the first year I went. I met all of them. This was in 2016, so 2 years ago. So I've been going ever since then. I'm gonna make a tradition forever, for as long as I can remember. It's not too bad. It's only like 6 hours from where I live. And I'm not so, there's so many new releases for makeup and stuff. Comment down below what new products you guys wanna get, because I really want the Soft Glam palette by Anastasia. I want their new liquid lipsticks because they literally give me life. Their blue one, I'm not one for color because my wardrobe is literally black. I feel like black is slimming on my thick body type. I don't know. I like my thickness. Sorry. That was really bad. I'm creasing because I just, whatever. That's okay. I look super red on camera, but in person I don't look red at all. They want to try out their bronzers and the Amorisi highlighter. Oh, I can't. For my lower lash line, I'm going in with this Eco Tools. This came in a set. I actually got this from BK as well. This is for my Christmas present. This is the liner smudge brush. It is super, super small.
I use this to blend out my liner. I feel like this is not blended. I'm sorry. Hold on. Where's my brush? Okay. I feel like this is not blended on the edge enough, and it's...
So I'm gonna go in, and I'm gonna go in with the shade Hangry and Pizza, and I'm just gonna run that across my lower lash line. This brush makes a lower lash line so much easier. I used to take like a big brush like this and try to do it. It just did not work at all. Go in with the, yet another Eco Tools brush. This is the detail liner brush. I don't know if I'd use it for liner. It's not my thing. I like using this for my inner corner, and I am going to go in with the shade Cube. I'm gonna actually flip it so it's the right way. Cube, which is just like this a little bit with my setting spray. Oh, I just sprayed my hand. Okay, I'm gonna go in, and that is doing absolutely nothing. Oh. I mean, you can't really see. It looks a little blue, actually. I don't know what's going on right now. I'm just gonna keep trying to. Okay, there we go. I had to build it up a little bit. That looks kind of blue. Can't even see it on camera. Okay. It's really pretty. My brow bone with that shade. I'm actually gonna go over my Cupid's bow to kind of give it more dimension. I do have really small lips, which I'm really sad about. So now I'm gonna set my entire face with this NYX Dewy Finish spray. I love this. Like I said, I do have combo skin, but I really like how the way this makes my face feel. A lip color. Actually, no, I'm gonna do my lashes. I have been obsessed with this Maybelline Colossal Volume Express. So with my mascaras, I really don't like a lot of product on them because I don't like my lashes looking clumpy. So I just like to remove a little bit. It's gonna be on the sides, or I'll take like a makeup wipe. Fun fact, I don't use makeup wipes, I use baby wipes. They're so much cheaper and they last longer, and they remove my makeup just as well. Oh yeah, I didn't wipe off enough product. So I'm just gonna go in and wipe off the product, and you guys are probably like, that's wasting. This is the Anastasia Liquid. No. This is the Anastasia Lip Gloss in the shade Bedurox. I don't know. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing it wrong. I can't. It's like a nice red shade. I have very, very pointy lips, and it looks kind of weird. That's okay, my phone keeps. So, that is it for my little chit-chat get ready with me. I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you did, definitely give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!